Once again, I welcome you all to the second session of this third day. This session, guest our resource person, Professor R. Jagannathan, sir, our IQAC coordinator, and he is the associate professor and head of the Department of Mathematics, INRR Janakimal College, Sivakasi, coordinator of IQAC, nodal officer for IIC, and member of MKU Academic Council. Gold medalist and university third rank holder in MSc Mathematics, 34 years of teaching experience, 8 years of experience as executive member, and 3 years as coordinator of IQAC. He reviewed the SSR of NAC accreditation for the colleges, Fatima College, Madurai, and Fatima College, Madurai, and Kamaraj College, Tuticorin. Developed an OBE model, and the institution is right now following. Our college OBE model is coined, implemented, and successfully we are undergoing the OBE pattern because of the able guidance of Dr. Professor Jagannathan sir. We are happy to announce you that this also. Organized 3 state level workshops in mathematics, organized workshops for mentee institution as IQAC coordinator under UGC Parama scheme. As chairperson, revised the program scheme and syllabus for BSc Mathematics twice. He acted as external member of IQAC of Ramco Institute of Technology and EMG Yadava College for Women. Presented guest lectures on outcome-based education at GVN College, Kovilpatti, and EMG Yadava College for Women, Madurai. He acted as an external academic auditor for Fatima College and SFR College, Sivakasi, and Kutralam Parasakti College. He organized 7-day workshop through webinar to faculty members of Kamaraj College, Tuticorin, on institutional preparedness to face the re-accreditation framework of NAC. So in a nutshell, he is IQAC coordinator, and under his guidance, Anjak implemented OBE, and now he completed all the tasks under the UGC Parama scheme, which is sanctioned by UGC for our college for a worth of 30 lakhs. And for all the laurels of the Anjak, he is the man behind that one. And above all, he is a well-hearted, kind person, and a very good motivator and guiding us in the right direction. That because of his guidance only, I am able to get this FDP grant from ATL. So I wholeheartedly thank you, sir, for this opportunity. Because of the guidance only, we have attained this one. And he is among us as a resource person. It is a very privileged. We are all blessed and privileged with his presence. On behalf of our college, I welcome you to this session, sir. Now I hand over the session to you. Thank you, sir.
Welcome. Thank you, sir. Madam. Thank you, madam. Thank you for giving us a lot of compliment. Good morning, everyone, participants. At the outset, I appreciate the participants for choosing this particular FDP. Actually, there are a lot of choices of FDPs are available to choose from the core areas also. But these participants have chosen this particular FDP means that you are all some inclination and interest on this social service. So hats off to you, everyone. Now we shall get into the topic. On 4th October, I gave inaugural address stressing the need for community services by higher education institution. And here also, before entering into my today's topic, I would like to mention certain points which I have raised in the inaugural address. Mm-hmm. My topic for today's session is supplementary teaching as support service to marginalized children. Before entering into the topic, as I said here, I would like to mention certain things which I have delivered in my inaugural address. Community service should be higher education institutions' commitment. It should be a commitment, it should not be a compulsion. Even though the interest in community services increases among students and staff, systematic approaches and practices have to be in place. And nowadays, everyone is doing some sort of community service. But my stress here is institutions have to have some systematic approaches to make everyone involved in the community service. NAC 2 gave better score if we involve more students and staff in the community service. As far as NAC is concerned, the metrics regarding extension services are of two type. The one is how many extension activities an higher education institution has done in the 5-year period. This is one question. And the second question is how many students and staff involved in it. So the focus will be not on just how many services rendered, how many students participated will also be counted. Actually, in the second question, in the denominator, the whole of the whole strength of the college will be there. Say, for example, suppose an institution has 5,000 students doing some BSc or MSc courses. Then how many among these 5,000 participated in the extension activity will be the formula. So number of activity alone will not give us the right mark for getting better grade. The next thing I just want to stress here is the allotment of mandatory credits for extension and community services in the program scheme itself. So only then we make everyone involved in the activity. Another point is institutions have to recognize the community service on par with other academic achievements. Say, for example, we usually appreciate the students who bring laurels to the institution by winning intercollegiate events. Similarly, we give medals, gold medals and prizes to academic achievers. Similarly, it should be a practice to have appreciation for students and staff who involve in community service. Only this kind of movement will help, will motivate others to participate in the community service. Next, third important point is topics for projects and field work focusing the society needs should also be permitted. Instead of giving topics in the core area, we can also provide topics to those students who are interested to help the farmers or the society people. In my today's lecture, as a resource person, I am going to talk on supplementary teaching to children of neighborhood community. Next slide, ma'am. Next. Yes. Why should we provide supplementary teaching? Very big question is, why should we provide supplementary teaching? Globally, the spread of education increases manifold and takes different dimensions. $1 trillion of money are being spent on education systems globally. Actually, nowadays, private multinational companies entered into teaching sector. Actually, we can say that it is not teaching sector, it is coaching sector. These private players, they entered into the coaching sector, making the education a costly affair. Every day, different companies sell different products. That is, there are products for scoring good marks in different streams of plus two. There are various streams, state board, ICSE, there are different boards. And for each board, there are different packages are there to score good marks. And another thing is, there are products for clearing NEET UG, NEET PG, JEE, IIT JAM, GATE, and so on. So for every coaching, there is a product. The product may be a package. Next slide, madam. Education is now conveyed through tablets, applications, and through virtual platforms. Educational content development and delivering them attractively to children are currently big business. But to my knowledge, only those who spend huge money and a lot of time can only join and clear exams with the good scores. That is, all these digital transformations are becoming way of life of only to the children of well-off families of urban population. Only the big shots are able to join in these private sponsored education or coaching system. Dear participants, next slide, madam. Dear participants, some of the problems, I just want to mention various problems that beset education at schools in rural areas of India. Here, my aim is not to demotivate or degrade any individual or institution or government, but I just looking at this kind of reality in my neighborhood society, and that is what written here. These are some of the problems which I realize. Digital divide between urban and rural children. The rural children are not getting the same treatment as that of the urban students. Next is poor quality of teachers, a lack of provision to update the knowledge of teachers. There is no provision, or the government or the local body is not taking up this as a big concern. The teacher-student ratio is also very poor. Sometimes a single teacher handle multiple classes from 1 to 5. These are happening in many parts of our country. Next is lack of teaching tools and materials. They just sit and teach for the entire group of students without taking any effort. The influence of poor economic conditions of parents that force the students to absent classes frequently. So these are some of the problems that surround the education at schools in rural areas of India. That is why I said that the education provided to the students in rural area is entirely different to that of that is provided in an urban area. So rich family are having better scope for getting all these through the costly material. Next. So under these settings, I would like to carry forward the rest of my speech. So my solution to all these problems is that supplementary teaching is an answer to most of these problems. Next. Dear participants, as I was introduced by the coordinator of this program, Dr. Vasanthi, I am basically a mathematics teacher and also served in the IKAC for more than a decade. So my contents may have some influence on the contents of today's topic. And as faculty members, you all have some more better ideas or proven strategies to provide community service. I think definitely you all encode this kind of community service in your institution, and you may participated in many of the activities. So your ideas may be different from the one I project here. Now I am going to expose a certain community services which are offered in our college. Hence I will give some more time for the audience also at the end of the session to expose your views. So at the end of the session, you will be provided some time to expose your views on this community service. If you provide one or two points, that may be useful for others also. So please be ready to exhibit your thoughts in a national forum like this to reach different parts of this country. Okay, let us move on to the main content. First one is different dimensions and strategies which one can apply on different departments. First one is mathematics department. Usually in our college, mathematics department provide support to school children to move ahead in their learning path. Community development and welfare activities. We provide a teaching demonstration, a promotion of mathematical skills, helping differently abled children in their learning process. These are some of the dimensions and strategies we apply in our college. Usually mathematics is a different topic where the teaching, however big the teacher is, he may not reach the entire audience of the class. So some sort of models are required to make it simple. So usually in our department, we go to different schools and teach mathematics, showing different models and games, and sometimes competitions. We conduct competitions to make things easier for the students to understand. Next slide. For physics department, these are some suggestions from our side. Awareness on astronomy, that is observing celestial objects. The physics department, they have some tools to observe the celestial objects, the Venus and so on, moon. And we allow the school children to view the objects, the celestial objects, through these instruments. And another thing is energy, awareness on energy consumption techniques. This is also very important one. And repairing and serving domestic appliances. Some basic thing behind repairing, how to repair some simple repairs in domestic appliances. As far as chemistry is concerned, chemistry in day-to-day life and safety measures, water quality analysis, checking the quality of the water they are using, preparation of soap, liquid detergent, candles to help them to earn some money. So these are some techniques we apply to motivate the students and also the general public on physics and chemistry side. Apart from this, the DST has a special program called Inspire. Here also, institutions can apply for funding agency fund from this Inspire program. And the government is providing some money for the institutions to conduct activities during summer. This is also a good initiative to involve the rural students in the college during summer programs. Next slide. Yes. Actually, in the previous lecture, Dr. Vairamuthu gave you a lot of options to use technology for community service. These are some elementary work which we do as part of our extension activity. Practicals to school children in the college campus itself. Awareness program on computer hardware and software. Internet basics and the usage. Send and receive email. Design logos and invitations. And basics of spreadsheet, that is Excel and its usage. So these are the certain activities. Apart from these, the department is also helping the local people in different ways. In our college, actually, they are helping, not only helping the students, but also helping the local body people for their official work. They also help them to know the various aspects of computer and the technology for using properly. Next slide. From the botany department, display of live specimens, microscopical observation and plant structure, species diversity in campus, and also create and maintain gardens. We also provide some basic things to maintain garden, kitchen garden or garden in houses. For zoology, we are the techniques we are applying are nutritional awareness, hemoglobin checkup, blood group identification, and virtual dissection. These are the strategy we are using. From the microbiology and biotechnology department, we offer awareness program on biofertilizer production and also vermicompost awareness. We also educate them to prepare vermicompost. Next. For Tamil, Hindi, English, or for any other language, the grammar, the communication skill can be taught through word game or vocabulary building game or missing word game. So interestingly, our students and staff enter different schools in the nearby schools and teach them different things interestingly. That is the important thing. Writing poems, verses, and criticisms. Training students to appear for different levels of Hindi examination. This is also, as Hindi is a national language, our department, even though the department has only 2 members, they are doing excellent service in helping the students to pass the various levels of Hindi examinations. The Hindi department is also conducting various competitions also, various district level competitions, and so that they create some interest on Hindi. Next thing is environmental awareness program, tree plantation program, street plays to create awareness. Language departments can offer street play as a tool to to create awareness. And here awareness, I mean, different things can be given to the general public as well as the students. We can convey the government policies and the ecosystem, the conservation of ecosystem. As I said earlier, we can use the other department also to the technique can be used. Archaeological things collection, cultural heritage and social practices. These are certain things we are using from the language departments. Next. Different dimension strategies adopted by the commerce, business administration and economics. E-resources for accounts, mobile banking, savings, promotion of savings habit, various serious savings options available in the banks and post offices are exposed. From the business administration department, management games, task completion games, team building games are offered. And the economics department do a lot of different things. Consumer awareness and as consumer rights, economic survey. Actually, our economics department some years back conducted the economic survey of the Virudhunagar district and in collaboration with the Tamil Nadu government. It is an excellent survey that will project the capacity of the local neighborhood. Next slide. Yes. So far, we have seen various strategies we are offering. Now, let us see. All these are actually implemented in our neighborhood by Ayanad Arjani Himal College. The first one is supplementary teaching by mathematics department. As I said earlier, mathematics department teach mathematics, the basics of mathematics through games or by showing models, by conducting competitions. We do a lot of work. This is happening for more than 10 years. We use this strategy to connect the neighborhood community. Next. Grammar and spoken English through language games. Next. Training students to appear for different levels of Hindi examinations. As I said, the Hindi department will also offer different competitions for district level competitions for school children. Next. Microscopical observation. We allow students to look at various. We not only allow the microscopical observation, we actually allow the school children to visit the laboratories of different departments. Next. Students observing live specimens available in the zoology department. Next. Computer training in the campus itself for school children. And this is by the economics department, delivering awareness lecture on women empowerment and the need of energy. A village near city. Motivation program for differently abled children. Here also we involve students and staff. And this one is a very recent one conducted on 29/3/21. It is done in Elvin Center, CSI School for Mentally Retarded Children. Motivated the special children of Elvin Center through different games. Next. Motivation program for orphanage homes children. Organized street play to create drug awareness among the public at a village. Extension activity of awareness program on biofertilizer production technology for a farmer at a village in the Virudhunagar district. Next. Science exhibition. This one is another important aspect the college is doing for the society. Every 2 or 3 years, we offer the science exhibition. We conduct a science exhibition to nearby schools in our campus itself. Actually, if you zoom the content, you will see that it is actually done by different departments involved in it. Hindi, Tamil, Mathematics, Physics, Computer Science, Chemistry, almost all the departments involved in 2 day science program. Between, for 2 days, we organize the science exhibition. And this is a way to expose scientific or indulge scientific thinking among students. This is another way of giving chance to both our students as well as the school student to mingle and enjoy the learning of science. Next. Yes. This is also a program on INSPIRE. As I said earlier, institutions can apply for funding from the DST for INSPIRE program for conducting summer programs. 5 or 6 days program, they sponsor for the entire program. We can choose students from rural area and we can provide training for the whole day duration. Next. Next, the benefits of supplementary teaching. As I said, as given in the last line, when we conducted a scientific science exhibition, nearly 4,300 students participated from 59 schools in our Anjak science exhibition. So popularizing the scientific thinking is a base, is the motivation for celebration of Science Day. Exhibition to school children develop an inclusive growth. This kind of supplementary teaching brings a greater quality in education system addressing the right of the students. Next. We also support human development through this supplementary teaching. And the supplementary teaching also fills the gap between what is taught and what is learned by showing models, pictures, and the various other modes. To create interest and to help enjoy learning through games, puzzles, role play, these are various strategies we adopt. To recommend measures to improve teaching learning at the schools, so that the standard of teaching learning improves at the grassroots level. And providing supplementary teaching as another important thing is, we get better quality students. When we provide teaching to school students, we get good quality students in turn for college also. Next slide. Apart from helping nation building, supplementary teaching will give some additional benefits to the institution, which provides supplementary teaching and the participants who offer the service. Increase in institution's image. As we connect many institutions, the institution's name and the image, the prestige and the perception among neighborhood society increases, and I think that is most important one for any institution. Students learn a meaningful philosophy of life also. Apart from learning the subjects, they also learn meaningful philosophy. So it means those students who teach in this supplementary teaching, they're learning the philosophy of life. Next. the students who involve in supplementary teaching, the benefit of developing leadership quality in them, develop a stronghold on foundation of their, when we teach something, our students get some strong idea because they prepare a lot to face the students, and therefore they get some stronghold on the foundations of their subject also. With the children of schools as audience, the graduate students feel happy and they engage fully in the service. The audience give them some extra happiness to the students, a breather for the staff and students from the regular routine teaching and learning activities. Next. Yes, like corporate social responsibility, it is time for higher education institution to provide a social responsibility for better connection and contribution to neighborhood society. Actually, in our institution, there is a practice that is for every 3 or 5 years, we have some connections. We adopt villages, some 8 or 9 villages. So as per our principal's idea, every 3 or 5 years, we adopt different villages each time, 8 or 9 villages. And we provide supplementary teaching and the community service, and also through departments and also through various service agencies. We provide a different sort of help to the adopted villages, and thereby we are making this effort reach every part of the neighborhood of the college. Next. Thank you, friends, for patiently listening. As I said earlier, if one man cannot do a lot for this service sector, the society needs a lot of people to join. A lot of awareness programs are essential. What I have shown you is only limited. I know you may engage in different sort of activity, and I think you can raise question, or you can put forth any of the new idea which you employ as a social service sector in the society. So now it is time for you to register your thought also. If you have any new idea, please come forward and register your thought. Any new ideas implemented as part of any of your institution may be shared here in this forum.
Sir, good afternoon. This is Vairamuthu.
Yes.
Additionally, as you said, we in the IT used to have frequent trainings to farmers.
Okay.
Every year we used to have, and we used to also arrange for the exhibition stuff so that the farmers can showcase their products there. This is one thing. Okay. And for self-group people, self-group help group, women, we used to have training once every 6 months. So we have business incubation cell. They used to arrange for those kinds of training also.
And we can also arrange them to sell their product in the campus.
Yes, sir.
Also.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. And yes, sir. Then additionally, for police personnel and other related personnel, we used to give some sort of technical training. As you said, you insisted you are going to, you used to give some trainings on Excel, everything. Very similar way, we used to give some sort of internet related or how to use an app, how to use internet services. We also used to give them for police personnel. And additionally, we have CDMM, Center for Disaster Mitigation and Management. Center for Disaster Mitigation and Management. Wherein we used to invite people from first aid, that is a fire service department, and we used to give them additional training. In addition to this, we also this CDMM was also part of a major disaster. We used to analyze some data, and we have also given some support even from Nepal. We are rendering our services. So just I wanted to add with your points, which are adapted in our institution, sir.
Thank you, Professor Vairamuthu, sir, for sharing your ideas nicely.
Thank you, sir.
I hope this will be helpful to others also. As I said, there are a lot of other ways to do community service. Here I have exposed only one side of the community service, because the topic I have chosen is supplementary teaching. So the most of my topic, my focus will be on teaching the children. But as Professor Vairamuthu said, there are other ways to help the neighborhood community. Well done. Any other points to register here?
Sir, can I speak?
Yes, madam.
Our institute is basically in Bangalore, an urban area. So our faculty teach on using kitchen waste for mushroom culturing.
Okay.
And also we teach about vermicomposting, especially in a small unit of this one terrace pit and all. So these two activities we teach for the neighborhood.
Okay, madam. Okay, fine, madam.
Thank you, ma'am. Others can also suggest or post your opinion. Are any queries you may ask now?
If you ask, if you register at least one different activity, it will go other areas also for implementation. That is the motive.
Or you can suggest, you can think and give, this may be done from my own discipline. If you are from management, or if you are from mathematics, or if you are from engineering background, what are the activities that is for related to supplementary teaching? Or for the benefit of the children, what are the activities we can render as pertaining to your discipline?
Good afternoon, sir. Shall I add?
Yes, yes, madam.
Sir, this is Aruna Devi from Kristu Jayanti College, Bangalore.
Yes.
Sir, it was a nice explanation with photographs and other activities. Thank you so much, sir.
Yes.
I want to add two activities which in our department, like computer science department, what we have done. We call training of trainers, wherein our college, we have a professional development forum. As a part of it, a small unit, what we have is Center for Life Skill Education. So wherein we have certified life skill trainers. So these trainers, they actually train government school teachers and whichever institute who are demanding, they used to go and teach them life skills actually, so that they can train, they can give life skills to their their college or institution. So that is from the teacher side. The other one is the same thing, training TOT, that is training of trainers. We train our students. And we get requests from the nearby, government schools or whichever the schools, wherein they need a temporary teaching assistance or a teachers. For example, recently one school, they didn't have a computer science teacher for some time. So that time, we deputed our students, weekly, some 3 hours basis. So the postgraduate students, they used to go and teach them practical classes and all. These students are already trained by us. So they go and teach these things, and they conduct the pre-assessment and post-assessment, all these stuffs. So this one way, pertaining to, the teaching activities, I wanted to share it with you, sir.
Yes, you. Excellent. Excellent idea. And students are acting as part-time teachers. It is a good idea. Madam, what is the role of this Center for Life Skill Training? What kind of training is provided there, madam?
The Center for Life, we have the coordinators and directors who are already trained by Rajiv Gandhi, the institute, sir. So this thing we have started from the year 2012. So every year we start with the training of the new teachers. So since I joined in the year 2013 in Krishna Jayanti, so that time we have undergone the training. We got the certificate from Rajiv Gandhi Institute itself. And so now what we will do is the first years for them, the moment when they join in, so first 10 days they will go for this life skill training. So we will train them on the 10 skills which are identified. And then, for PG, UG, we used to train them. So the same way, like when there is a requirement from outside, we used to go and do the same training. So they have, even the teachers have some assessment. So though that all the teachers are trained, they have identified some levels of teachers. So those teachers will go out and do a kind of consultancy also, sir.
Nice, madam. Well done. I think the center can also be used to teach the teachers of the neighborhood community also.
Yes, sir. That's what, sir. That's what we used to do, sir.
Nice idea. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
In the final, in the first slide also, I said the quality of teachers and the provision of teaching teachers is also less in our country. So this is our responsibility, the institutions of higher education's responsibility to teach the teachers also. Excellent idea, madam.
Sir, can I speak?
Yes, madam.
In our college, we have a Red Cross club, or it can be called as Red Cross unit. They conduct this blood donation camp, and during COVID time, they were helping the community for finding the bed because there was a lot of bed scarcity in the hospitals. So they were helping in booking the ambulance and all. They've done a very good job during pandemic also.
Okay. Nice, madam. Nice. Actually, as I said in the previous lecture end, we are actually clueless on how to take forward this extension service during this pandemic time. I think you are giving some suggestions in this direction. Thank you. Thank you, madam.
Welcome, sir.
In the comment session, Dr. N. Uma Shankari, her comment is proposed to install artificial intelligence center in our campus for adopted school children. Ma'am, can you explain what is the role to be played by the center on the student improvement? Can you explain, ma'am?
In what way artificial intelligence can be useful to the community service, madam?
Thank you, sir. Sure, sir. For that purpose only, we just proposed it. We requested our management and principal to install such an artificial intelligence center in our campus itself for the maintenance purpose. And we will bring the school children from the adopted villages to our campus to give training in the science experiments, sir. They can do by their own. And last year, we conducted a program for the school children of 12th standard at Sitarajapuram Higher Secondary School to insist on STEM, science, technology, mathematics. So in that category, we have, as an initiative, the chemistry department conducted a program to give hands-on training in the plus two practicals, sir. So this time we are going to extend with all other departments, science departments.
Yes. Wonderful, wonderful service, madam.
Thank you, sir.
One more comment from Anuradha. We assist teaching and non-teaching staff and all students in MS Office and now in Google platform, those didn't aware of computer and mobile from computer science department. Very good, ma'am. Others, you may think and provide one or two suggestions or proposed activities also. If you already practice, you may post here, or if you are going to propose, that can also be given as a comment.
Apart from teaching support, institutions can also support the neighborhood schools by way of donating computers or any of the equipments which are outdated in which are outdated or not up to the mark of higher education. They may be given to the neighborhood schools, and this is the idea given by our principal, and we are finding ways to donate this kind of articles to the neighborhood government schools. I think this is also a useful idea here. Okay, madam, is there any other question or shall we conclude the session?
No more suggestions or questions are there, sir.
Okay. With this, I conclude my lecture and hand over the session to the coordinator of the program, Dr. Jabakumari Beulah Vasanthi. Thank you, madam. Thank you, audience, for watching me. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your wonderful session, and you have provided a very good ideas in the title Supplementary Teaching and for the Marginalized Children. Also, you have obtained several suggestions from the audience, and you have thanked for your appreciation and wonderful comments. Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you.
Participant, I will share the attendance link and feedback link of both the session. Kindly fill it up. Try to attend all the sessions without fail. For some more minutes also, you have to attend the meeting. And also, we are getting attendance from the Zoom also. So not only filling up the attendance is essential, but you have to get benefit out of the session, because all the resource persons are preparing for so many, by spending their valuable time. So remember that also. And they are providing one or other new initiatives that can be, definitely that will be useful for our academic institution in the community services area. And it is need of an hour also in the third criteria of NAC, as well as in the MBA accreditation also, they are asking for what we have rendered to the society. And each and every research work is also be part and parcel of the society oriented. So remember that also. So this kind of forum will definitely give a new idea. And today from the first session as well as from the second session also, I have also got several ideas. So we have to transfer the knowledge that we have obtained through our experiences, through our intellectual, through our reading and other resources. We have to transform it to the society in one or other form. So definitely will be benefited by what you have learned today. So kindly attend the FDP without any delay or without any fail. So I request all of you to attend the FDP for some or other way. Thank you, and I will share the attendance link to you as well as the feedback form. And we'll meet after the lunch break and at 2 p.m. sharply. Thank you, one and all.